it is Yuga Bapara watching this video. And today, if you have noticed or not, I'm cosplaying as Jhansi Lakshmi Bai. So I hope you like my cosplay. And also, I've done this because in the honor of Independence Day celebrated in India on 15th August. So it's upcoming in 2 days and I'm really excited for it. And before you get started, if you like this video, subscribe if you haven't already and turn on the post notification. And without further ado, let's get started. Rani Lakshmi Bai. Rani Lakshmi Bai or Jhansi Ki Rani, the Queen of Jhansi, was one of the leading figures of the rebellion of 1857. For Indian nationalists, she became an icon of the freedom struggle against the British Raj for India. November 19th, the birth anniversary of Rani Lakshmi Bai, is celebrated as Martyrs' Day in Jhansi to honor the lives lost in the rebellion of 1857. Who was Rani Lakshmi Bai? Rani Lakshmi Bai was one of the warriors of India's struggle for independence, was born as the Manikarnika Tambal in 1828 in Varanasi. She lost her mother at the age of 4 and was raised in an unconventional way by her father, who worked as an advisor in the court of Peshwa. He supported her in learning housemanship, archery, self-defense and shooting. In 1842, Lakshmi Bai got married to Gangadhar Rao Nevalkar, the Maharaja of Jhansi, and got the name of Rani Lakshmi Bai few years after marriage in 1851. Manikarnika gave birth to a boy, but he couldn't survive and died after 4 months. Then Lakshmi Bai and Gangadhar Rao adopted Rao's cousin's son, Anand Rao, who was later named as Damodar. Soon after they adopted Anand, also known as Damodar, Maharaj died due to the illness in 1853. Rani Lakshmi Bai was just 18 at the time. The East India Company took advantage of the Maharaja's death and applied the doctrine of lapse. Revolt of 1857. Many factors led to the revolt of 1857, but the main factor was the introduction of greased cartridges by the Eastern India Company. The sepoys had to bite the cartridge of the new Enfield rifle by their teeth. This was unacceptable to the soldiers as their cartridges were greased with beef and pork. Shocked at the Britishers' attempt to taint religion, the soldiers joined hands and collective immunity. It is believed that prior to sepoy immunity, Lakshmi Bai was unwilling to rebel against the British but changed her mind in 1858. When commanding officer of the British forces, Sir Hug Rose, demanded the surrender of Jhansi Lakshmi Bai. Lakshmi Bai gave a great fight to the British as the siege of Jhansi lasted for about 2 weeks. After the fierce war, when the British army entered Jhansi, Rani Lakshmi Bai tied her son Damodar Rao to her back and fought bravely using 2 swords in the back of her hands. She escaped to Kalpi and was accompanied by her other rebels. She then departed to Gwalior and a fierce battle was fought between the British and Lakshmi Bai's army. So guys, that's the end of this video. I hope you learned a lot about our great warrior, Rani Lakshmi Bai, and I really respect her and how she fought for our country, India. And let's all join our hands and pray for all the soldiers and armies which are in the northern Indian states. So also, once again, happy Independence Day to all, and I hope you're enjoying this day very heartfully. And thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you haven't already, and turn on your post notifications. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.